Welcome back, folks, to HPI Guys Model Workshop. This Labor Day weekend, we are going to be building up a muscle car. Yes, Labor Day, Americana, muscle cars, they all go together. It is steaming hot in Wisconsin this weekend, so I'm going to spend the weekend kayaking and partying with my friends while you watch this video, and then you can join us if you can find me on the lakes in central Wisconsin. We are going to be building up the 1970 Ford Torino Cobra by Revell USA. This is in 1/25th scale. It has a total of 128 parts, and let me tell you, a sweet, sweet decal sheet, but we'll get to that towards the end. I'll make you wait. Let's start seeing about all the plastic that's in the box. First up, you'll see that most of the trees or all of the actual car parts are in white styrene, that nice plastic that Revell USA has been using that reacts well to my glue. The glue I like to use on my kits is Plastruct Bondine. It works really well, and this kit and that glue will be available at modelroundup.com. I will link in the description where you can snag that. We've got some really beautiful detailing. Excellent tooling on this kit, and it looks very crisp. Open louvers, open hood. Look at the little mini scoops. We got bumps for the hood pins, or hood locks technically. Got our vent there. That looks awesome. Got our hood scoop. Air cleaner intake. There's the rest of our scoop there. That looks tough. Those door panels are outstanding. Really sharp detail. Underhood detail on the hood itself is very nice, and you've got the bumps for the optional hood hinges and springs. Next up is the factory dashboard. This builds a stock Torino. It's not a two-in-one kit. It builds a nice stock Torino, or I hope a nice stock Torino. Got spindles on the front. Those look very delicate. Be careful. We got manifolds, full exhaust system molded in one piece with the crossover pipe, drive shaft. Springs are separate from the differential. Brake booster. Center console looks awesome with the engraving. So does the rear seat. Steering column. Be very careful with your turn signal indicator. So that's the other tree. We've got the chassis tree, and man, that looks busy. Check out the shadowing on that. Holy cow. Definitely tell this is a much newer mold. This says 2000 on it, and they probably went through and made sure the tooling was cleaned up for this run. Bucket seats in the front, seat backs are separate pieces. We've got engine fans, belts and pulleys, starters, distributor with vacuum on it. Even has a coil, so this should build into a very detailed engine. I'll let you look at the top so you can see your suspension arms up there. Another tree, so many parts in this kit. Got our floor pan with carpet detail, even the mats in there for our shifter console. Got our radiator support, got our firewall. Engine and transmission package. Three pedals, shock absorbers are really fine on this one. Got our mirrors right there, so we'll have to cut those out, get those for body color. Oil pan, and we'll show you the flip side for the detail. Look at that, it's even got a transmission cooler. Isn't that nice? Final individual tree, wheel backs, front discs on this ride, suspension, sway bars, and steering links, and the stock steering wheel. Finally, we get to that sweet Torino body. It's even got open holes for the marker lights on this thing. Ay caramba. Trim, got our vents here. Inner fenders. Pretty sweet looking. The door panels are a hair shallow, but we know we use one of those nice markers. Model Roundup sells these as well. These black liners by Molotow, they work very well. They go right into the grooves. The trim looks good. The wiper blades are molded in. We got little indentations for the mirrors. And super, super fine bump there. Got our mirrors, super fine bump there for the door handle. Super shallow though, so watch where you glue on that. The trim looks strong enough that I can get my Sharpies or a Molotow in there. Excellent body work on there. Let's flip sides to the other side of the desk. We've got our singular chrome tree with the smooth bumpers. We got our grill, which makes it easy to get in here and paint this black. Or we can always, I put silly putties in the headlight buckets, spray the whole thing black, and then use the Molotow just to do the center, which works out just as well. We got our valve covers on here, carburetor, exhaust tips, right there, one set of wheels. So you'll basically be building the box art on this one, or enhancing it and changing it any way you want, but you have to do that on your own. Got our wheel, and we got our tire package here. Wide-ish. Nowadays, tires are twice as wide, but back then, this was considered a wide tire. Smooth wall, all the way around. Semi-hollow, but mostly rigid. Just a little thin line in the middle where it's open. We've got our clear glass tree. Marker lights there. Headlights. Windshield with mirror mount and back glass. Crystal clear molding on the clear styrene. We've got a transparent red tree for our taillights and rear markers, which look like they're going to mount from the inside. That's cool. I haven't seen that on a kit like that before. And finally, the decal sheet. Is this not cool? I had mentioned it. People in the comments had mentioned it. Revell USA listened. We get a full hood blackout. The whole deal with the pinstripes and everything done for us. Which means if you just want the pinstripe and you want to paint the rest, you can take an X-Acto and slice it out. It's a clear carrier in there. Or you can do the whole hood, or you can paint it and paint your own pinstripe. But this really gives us speedier builders a nice option. We've got the Firestone wide oval logos on the decal sheet. We've got the Twister special logos, license plates, CJ170. We got the Cobra logos for the rocker panels. We've got full dash instrumentation. We've got some alt Twister logos, Cobra logos, Ford logos. We've got the Cobra logos for the front fenders. We've got everything to duplicate. We got the auto light emblems, all the little underhood emblems, an amazing decal sheet in this kit. And that wraps up. Whew. That is a long unboxing. There's a lot of stuff in this kit. I'm going to start gluing my 74 Torino Cobra together, and I'll see you in that session in just a moment. Thank you.
Thank you.
It's a detailed kit, but it's not hard to assemble at all. It goes together very, very easily. Could be a person's first glue together kit. So far as this part of the video is done. I haven't done any final fits yet. I haven't put the interior in, but getting this far, very easy. I started cutting the parts trees apart. What I like to do is get these taken apart, and then I can start painting things up and remove them and doing my fine detail paintings or final coats. So you'll see a lot of stuff like that, and I'll try to put things together, like the mirrors that will have the body color and the front clip. The front clip will go into the body quite nicely. You see how well the hood fits. Goes in there without problems. This part of the body, I was wondering if I should glue it in place and risk it when I put the chassis together, but it won't be an issue because we'll be putting the grill into this, and then it looks like this will just fit up nice and tight in there. And I can glue the top edges up under the fenders there. I can glue these parts right up into the fenders and get that body piece on, so I'm not going to worry about that. The instructions have you put the rear body panel on, so we know that won't interfere with final fits. And then those louvers that we saw on the side, they ask you to sand those off, and that's what I did. I just removed those, and then I took what's called, where'd it go? It's called a scriber on the tool bench. It's a dental toothpicking tool. And I just reopened those body lines for the door panel because sanding right here, I kind of went over them. And I just scratched them back open. And they're quite shallow, so be very, 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 very careful when you reopen those. And you won't have any issues. So we got the body all set, got our interior panel ready. We've got that beautiful 429 all assembled, ready to go. That is a detailed engine. Goes together without trouble. I like to paint things separately at the end, so that's why I glue the manifolds on, the water pump and all that, distributor and vacuum, the coil. I enjoy keeping up my eyesight and dexterity by getting in there and hand painting after the major body color. Then we've got our belt and pulley system. We've got our alternator on the chrome tree. We've got our exhaust ready to go and our drive shaft. We've got the pedals attached to the dashboard. What else we got? We got our steering wheel and steering column glued together. On the bench here, we've got the seats. Those went together so nice. Look at that. Not even a seam. Those really turned out pretty darn fancy. We got the radiator support. Transmission cooler. It could be an oil cooler too. I'm not sure what they put on the 429s there. Commenters will know. That's a nice assembly. It's really multi-pieces. One, two, three, four, five pieces. Got the brace, the radiator itself, the shroud, and the support. So that's a really nice assembly there. Otherwise, just our wheel backs. We've got our shocks and springs. I'll paint those separately and attach those later. We got our battery on that tree. And then we get to the chassis to wrap this up. You saw me, I glued the axle together in position, and now I can remove it so I won't have to cut the exhaust on this one. It drops in very nicely. That will get paint on. We'll get gloss paint on that differential, and then the front suspension and steering went together. You can leave the steering poseable because the link snaps in place. I glued mine so that they're straight ahead. It's just a personal preference, but that looks awesome. So, detailed kit, easy to assemble, yet it's got enough detail that it doesn't drive you nuts. We've even got the hood scoop here, which we'll be painting a flat black with its air cleaner. That's a three-piece assembly. Really beautiful kit on this Torino. I am going to get everything over to the paint booth right now, and I will see you folks over there.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
It's been a pleasure to work on this kit so far, not having any issues with the way things fit. The glass goes in nicely. The interior, as you saw, goes in. I used Mod Podge to hold the glass in. The louvers are just sitting on there. And technically, you know, we could just, for photograph purposes at the end, we can just kind of set them up there and take them off, let you see both with the windows down so we can see inside the car. But those are going to look great when we're all done. I put the big decal on the hood because it has to conform to the inlets on the hood, the groove, and the air intake. And then we've got our hood pins in place. That just drops over and fits nicely over that. I've got the grill assembled. And that's going to look great on the front of the car. That's just going to pretty much just push up into place here once we get it all together. I'm not going to do it all right now on camera, but once we get it up in there, it'll line up. We have to shove it back farther. I'll do that once I get the body on. The radiator has just snapped up into place. That won't be a problem. Once we get it on the chassis, then I can push that radiator in the front. And then I've done the underhood detail, got our washer tank, brake booster, wiper motor, batteries in place. I just have to decorate the caps on the battery. Got the glass in there, and she is looking tight. Got the taillights glued in. Need some black decals on the trunk lid. Need to put our rear bumper on, but it is a sharp looking machine. Got those signal lights on, or those reflectors. The marker lights all the way around, orange in front, red in rear. She is looking tight, and that light blue looks beautiful on the car. The interior, you can see now way up inside there, did a light blue. Little different shade than the body. I used the black primer on the carpeted and the back deck, and then just gave it kind of a mist. And then you saw me puff over it to give it a little depth and a little bit of a flatness with that intermediate blue from Tamiya, which came out to look really nice, really realistic with a blue-on-blue interior. Not super fancy, got our center console there, and those decals really make the dash come to life for us with all the Cobra emblems. We go to the chassis, got that big honking 429 under the hood now, got our belt and pulley system on. Under the chassis, basic, you just got to get the power to the ground. I gloss coated the differential, painted our linkages and our sway bars, got our exhaust in place, got the shocks in place. The struts and the springs are going to be yellow on this one. We're not going to see them much, but painted those up when I painted the shocks, got our fuel tank. Exhaust tips have to go on once we get the body on, otherwise I'll probably snap them off. So that's it, and then we've got numerous decals under hood, tires, body logos, trunk, all that stuff, wheel centers. We got all kinds of stuff to put on there. Those wheels turned out beautifully with a wash inside of them. This kit's been going real good. Got to put our bumpers on. I got the marker lights installed in the bumper with some more Mod Podge. We've got those in. And then we don't want to forget when we're all done, these door handles scare me. The attachment points are massive. I hope I don't break them. And then we've got these itty bitty 429 logos that I blackwashed that I have to cut off and attach to the body as well. So probably got, with the decals and all the little fine points on there, maybe about an hour's left of work. I'm going to get to that right now. Once I get the decals, I will give us a gloss coat with future floor polish, and then we will come back for that final. I am all done with my 1970 Ford Torino Cobra from Revell USA. I know a lot of you are going to be super happy that this has been reissued. Of course, I've never built this kit before, but holy cow, is it a pleasant kit to build. Final assemblies go extremely easy. You slide the back of the chassis in, and then the front just snaps into place, and it sits as so with no adjustments whatsoever. The nose piece snaps in. I do have a little bit of gap on this side, which would be cured if you pressed it in, held it in, used some glue to hold it up tight and held it in place, but that's okay. You guys can work on that on yours, but otherwise the radiator goes in, the engine drops in, check it out. The hood sits in the right position and the hood scoop is where it should be, and I didn't have to mess with anything or unglue anything or snap anything loose or nothing. I went with a blue interior on mine because that's the kind of look. The box art looks really cool with the white interior, and that would have been my next choice. But I wanted to do a blue on blue. I Googled it. There are blue on blue Torino Cobra Jets. So I made one, and it looks awesome. I want to thank Revell for this excellent hood decal. With the pinstripes, it covers the whole hood, makes my job easier and more pleasurable. Those louvers are just on there with friction. We've got the beautiful wheel and tire package with the lettering. I had to use those big Cobra stripes on the side. I know the box art and the box build doesn't have it, but that's just too tough not to put on this car. The taillights glue into place with some Mod Podge. The rear bumper is a friction fit. The front bumper and grill is a friction fit. So if you press it in harder and use some glue, I'll be able to finish up that gap there. But I'm not worrying about it on mine. And it just sits right. Got the door handles on. Got those little 429 logos at the bottom of the fenders on there. Got the mirrors on. Didn't have any trouble. Be very, very careful when cutting out your door handles, as the tree they are on is a little bit thick. I did have to remove some material from the hood latches, from the hood pins, to get them to sit down far enough. They sat a little proud. They were a little thick as it is out of the box. The decals laid down beautifully. I had to reposition them a couple times, and they still went down lovely. Very interesting way to do the marker lights on this kit. I've never seen that before. I think it's pretty cool. All I had to do was use silver on the outside and then glue them in from the back with some Mod Podge. The interior is beautiful. I didn't know if a monotone interior with a little bit of a darker floor would work, but on this car, it definitely works, and I could easily see someone buying a Torino in this color option with this grabber style blue, and it just absolutely looks awesome. So I enjoy building the kit. Final assemblies went way, way easier than I thought they would. Thought I was going to have some trouble sometimes with these. It's sometimes a pain getting the body on. But this went on perfectly, and I had a great time building it. Model Roundup should have this in stock pretty soon. They put a notice on their Facebook page that they will be getting it in sooner than they expected, and that's why I decided to build this up right away. The kit is in 125th, has 128 parts in it, and will be great first time. Experienced modeler, anyone could get this, especially with that large hood decal making everything go so smoothly. As always, this is Chris with the workshop. Thanks for watching the show. Thanks for your nice comments. Thanks to all of you out there who say nice things or ask intelligent questions or give constructive criticism. We don't mind criticism on the show at all, but when you start screaming at people and calling them names, we're not a big fan of that. So thanks for watching the show. We'll see all of you at the next review.